So, and a lot of these are found in cycloalkanes. So the first one is angle strain, okay? Angle strain exists when tetrahedral bonds are forced out of their ideal bond angle of 109.5 degrees, okay? Remember that tetrahedrals always want to have 109.5, and the smaller your rings get, the more difficult it is for those carbon-carbon bonds to maintain that kind of bond angle. So let me just give you an example of a triangle. I'm not sure if you guys remember from geometry, but a triangle, if you have an equilateral triangle, each of these bonds is going to be, or each of these corners is going to be 60 degrees, okay? Is 60 degrees close to 109.5? Not even close. Remember that all of these carbons have two hydrogens. So what that means is that they are tetrahedrals and they want to have 109.5 bond angles, but they don't because of that stupid triangle. So what that means is that 60 is far less than 109.5, so this is going to be highly strained. And if it's highly strained, guess what that means? That means it's going to have high energy, and if it has high energy, then you can guess the rest. That means it has low stability. All right? So let's keep going. A square is a little bit better, actually a lot better. It's at 90 degrees, but that's still pretty far off from 109.5. All right, so in this case, this one's a little bit better, but still, it still has angle strain. Now, a five-membered ring is getting a lot closer to what we want. A five-membered ring will have bond angles of 108, and 108 is almost the same as 109.5. Like, there's almost no difference there. So in terms of angle strain, a five-membered ring cyclopentane has very little angle strain. Are you guys cool with that? It's almost perfect, okay? Then let's look at, finally, a six-membered ring. A six-membered ring would actually have bond angles of 120 degrees if it actually existed in this planar form, okay? Well, 120 degrees is way more than 109.5, so I would expect that a cyclohexane would actually be a less stable than cyclopentane. But actually, it turns out to not be true. Cyclohexane actually turns out to be the most stable ring out of all the rings, okay? You can make as many carbons, you can make tons of carbons, but cyclohexane is the most stable ring. Why is that? That if the bond angle is so off, oops, I didn't mean to do that. I meant to highlight it. If the bond angle is so off, if it's 120, then why would it be the most stable? Okay? And we're going to learn that in a little bit.